When my daughter was about 5 years old, she announced, "I love myself the most." In generations past, her declaration may have been viewed as self-centered, selfish, or self-absorbed, but I was beyond thrilled by her exuberant proclamation. And the reason for my glee was because at her tender age, falling in love with herself would be the secret to her happiness and a life fulfilled. Self-love motivates you to make healthy choices in life because when you hold yourself in high esteem, you're more likely to choose things that nurture your well-being and serve you well, especially when it comes to having healthy relationships with others.
Dear Family is a podcast hosted by Rachel Steinman, a writer, an educator, and a mental health advocate. And Rachel gets us up close and personal, so we feel a strong connection, familiarity, and comfort with her guests. So settle in and join us as we search for true healing and journey with Rachel and her most interesting guests.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Dear Family, the podcast. In fact, this is episode number 90. And when I first started this, I never thought I'd get this far. So thank you so much for listening and continuing to follow this podcast. It means so much to me. I am really excited to bring you this short solo podcast. What I am about to share is nothing that you have not heard before, but it is so important to be reminded. And during this holiday season, we realize the most important gift that we can give ourselves is self-love. It's not the jolliest season for everyone. So make sure to take care of your mental health and check in on your loved ones. Thank you so much for listening and subscribing to the Dear Family podcast and following me on all the social media platforms at Right Now Rachel. That's right with a W. If you want to share the Dear Family podcast with your dear friends and dear family, that's a wonderful gift for me. I'm wishing you the happiest holidays and may 2022 bring you all your heart desires. For those of you who love to read the corresponding essay, the link will be in the show notes. Take care of yourself and look out for others. Sending love back. The best gift of all is self-love. 24 free gifts to give yourself. As we approach this holiday season, the best gift of all for you and for mankind is the gift of love, and it begins with giving it to yourself. If everyone received this gift, peace, hope, and joy would spread on earth. A spirit so bright it would light up the world. When my daughter was about 5 years old, she announced, "I love myself the most." In generations past, her declaration may have been viewed as self-centered, selfish, or self-absorbed, but I was beyond thrilled by her exuberant proclamation, followed by her big, proud, and genuine smile. And the reason for my glee was because at her tender age, falling in love with herself would be the secret to her happiness and a life fulfilled. Her positive self-affirmation meant she would always put herself first, never let anyone walk all over her, and make sure she prioritized herself above anyone else. And I can honestly say she's not and has never been self-centered, selfish, or self-absorbed, and in fact is just the opposite. She continues to love herself into her young adulthood, attracting like-minded, loving people into her life, perpetuating a self-love cycle. She understood then, and she still does, that practicing self-love is the best gift she can give herself for a life well lived. Self-love is a state of being where you appreciate yourself, and it grows from actions that support your physical, psychological, and spiritual growth. Self-love means having a high regard for your own well-being and happiness. Self-love means taking care of your own needs and not sacrificing your well-being to please others. Self-love means not settling for less than you deserve. Self-love, like self-care, is not selfish. Self-love means accepting yourself as you are in this very moment and putting your physical, emotional, mental well-being first. Self-love motivates you to make healthy choices in life because when you hold yourself in high esteem, you're more likely to choose things that nurture your well-being and serve you well, especially when it comes to having healthy relationships with others. There's a reason self-love, self-respect, and self-worth all start with the word self. You can't find them in anyone else. You yourself have to do the work, but it's always worth the effort and the dividends pay off. If you were never allowed the space to grow up where self-love was encouraged and appreciated like my daughter was, when you do start exercising self-compassion and self-love for the first time, you may experience some discomfort and grief. You may come to the realization of how much you've actually missed and how certain people failed you and what the younger version of you actually deserved. Well, I'm here to remind you, it's never too late and you deserve self-love. Self-love can mean something different for every person because we all have many different ways to take care of ourselves. Figuring out what self-love looks like for you as an individual is an important part of your mental health. And to practice self-love, notice the word practice, start by being kind, patient, gentle, and compassionate to yourself. All right, so here we go. Here are 24 ways to practice self-love. Number one, prioritize yourself. You're number one and don't forget it. You can't move forward if you have no fuel in your tank. Put that oxygen mask on yourself first and then your energy will follow. You're number one and that's going to be the goal going forward with no guilt. The meaning of your life is to give your life meaning. Number two, wake up with a purpose. Write your goals down the night before by thinking about what needs to get done right away versus what can wait. And then prioritize them. Making that list the night before or the week before or however it works in your calendar will also help ease your mind for a better night's sleep. When your eyes open in the morning and you're rested, you'll have a game plan to follow. It's okay to veer off course sometimes, but just get back on track the next day. Number three, make a gratitude list and put yourself at the top. Be grateful for your body, your mind, your spirit, your sense of humor, your brain, your legs, your eyes, your mouth. The list can go on and on. You're a miracle, flaws and all. Number four, understand that self-discipline begins with small acts. If you can get something done in 5 minutes, why wait? Do it. Make your bed. Keep your desk clutter-free. Wash the dishes. Put your clothes away. Reply to that email. Take the stairs. Small steps in the right direction can turn out to be the biggest step of your life. Commit and follow through. You got this. And when you fail, because you will, remember failure is not the opposite of success. Failure is very much part of success, and it's achieved through self-discipline. Number five, trust yourself. Your gut instincts are those signs that you need to listen to because no one knows you better than yourself. If something doesn't feel right, it likely isn't. Number six, spend time each day doing something that you love and that matters to you and that makes you happy. It can be drawing or baking or looking at your fantasy football stats or listening to your favorite song or dancing or singing or hula hooping, whatever. Achieve self-love by getting involved in something you love. Number seven, celebrate the small wins. Don't wait for the big victories. Celebrating your small goals or crossing things off your to-do list along the way, that sparks the reward circuits of our brains and releases chemicals that give us a feeling of pride and increases the happiness factor, which makes us want to go further towards our next goal. Number eight, make room for healthy habits. Work out and eat healthy because you love your body, not because you hate it. Start caring for yourself by thinking about what you eat, how you exercise, and how you spend your time. Do stuff not to, quote, get it done, or because you, quote, have to, but because you care about yourself. Eating whole foods that are mostly organic may cost a little bit more at first, but your medical bills will be lower in the long run when your heart and your body are optimized. And that gym or that Peloton membership may be an investment every month, but it's not only helping your physical health, it's helping your mental health. Spend those extra few minutes to stretch. Your back, your hips, and your legs will thank you for it. Allow yourself room to indulge in your favorite foods, and to take time off from exercising once in a while. It's okay to chill. That is also part of self-love. Number nine, become mindful by getting in touch with your thoughts and feelings simply by noticing them. Don't react to them. Just notice them as you would notice white fluffy clouds floating by in the blue sky. People who have more self-love tend to know what they think, feel, and want. Anger, fear, and other negative emotions get in the way of being in the moment, stripping you of joy. Get out of your head. Stop overthinking. Get in touch with your body at the present moment and breathe. Number 10, don't fear intimacy with others and even with yourself. Yes, I'm talking about self-pleasure. There's no shame in it. Pleasing yourself is the epitome of self-love. And how else is a lover going to know how to please you if you don't know yourself? Self-intimacy is a critical step in getting to know ourselves so we can become closer to others. When you're in tune with your needs and your wants, and you find pleasure spending time alone with yourself, you'll attract others and make that time you spend together more meaningful and more joyous. Number 11, tell people you love and care about them. You are actually giving yourself love when you express love and appreciation to others. The law of attraction says it will come back to you. Number 12, practice random acts of kindness by treating others with love and kindness. Nothing is better than giving. It's a self-love boomerang. Number 13, ask for help if you need it. Asking for help is brave, and it means you love yourself enough to not quit and know you're worth fighting for. Number 14, self-care rituals like taking a warm bubble bath, sitting with your morning cup of coffee before the rest of the house wakes up, doing a crossword puzzle to keep your brain stimulated, journaling, snuggling a pet, following a skincare routine, or doing any simple self-care act that makes you feel good is fundamentally self-loving. Number 15, plain and simple, keep your promises to yourself. If you're searching for that one person that's going to change your life, take a look in the mirror. No one's going to make your dreams come true, only you are. You deserve to follow through for yourself. Number 16, speak to yourself the kind and loving way you speak to a loved one. Speak to yourself the way you want to be spoken to by a loved one. Talk to and about yourself with sincere love. When we talk to ourselves with compassion, we learn how to trust ourselves. Self-trust begins with self-worth, which leads to confidence. Maybe even consider giving yourself a high five in the mirror as you wink at yourself or tell yourself you love yourself. I know it sounds strange, but try it. Criticizing yourself does not work. Try approving of yourself and see what happens. Number 17, schedule fun in your calendar. Make time for day trips for your beloved friends and family, for concerts, for movies, for game nights, for laughter. Give yourself something to look forward to. The anticipation is part of the fun. Don't postpone enjoyment. Any opportunity to find joy, take it. Number 18, give yourself a break from self-judgment. Nobody is perfect, so why demand that from yourself? Do you want to be with someone who's perfect? That's boring. It's the imperfections that are often the most beautiful, and it's the cracks that allow for the light to come in. Number 19, put your damn phone down. Close your laptop. Take a break from social media and the fire hose of information coming at you 24 hours a day with technology connected to our fingertips and our brains. Stop scrolling and consider doing nothing, or at least something analog. Now, I admit, for me personally, this is a hard one, but one I feel so much better after doing. Number 20, allow yourself to cry. Sometimes it's the catharsis that you need. And I'm talking to everyone here, including the strong, manly men. Number 21, set healthy boundaries. It's okay to say no. Your time is valuable. The kindest, most authentic thing you can do for yourself and even for the other party is to say no quickly so it doesn't occupy more space than is necessary for your mind. Say something like, "Thank you so much for the invitation. I'm sorry I can't come, but I look forward to seeing you another time." Number 22, remember, it's okay to not be okay. Put your mental health first. It's immensely important. Nothing can take a physically strong person down faster than depression, anxiety, or any mental health crisis. Going to therapy, taking medication if you need it, and or prioritizing your mental wellness are paramount measures that are the basis of self-love and self-wellness. Take that mental health day if you need it. Number 23, forgiveness is one of the greatest forms of self-love there is because you don't forgive anybody else but for yourself. Forgiving others frees you from internal anger and pain. Forgiving yourself does the same. You're human. You make mistakes. Learn from them. Grow and evolve. become better and more compassionate. And last but not least, number 24, smile. It naturally boosts your mood and it makes you more attractive and more beautiful to others. And when you make yourself so happy, others who look at you become happy too, and it's a beautiful transference of love. Love yourself and be less concerned with the approval of others. You are so much braver, smarter, stronger, more capable, and more loving than you give yourself credit for. Believe in yourself and know that loving yourself deeply is the secret to being happy, finding true love, and becoming confident. Self-love is a journey. Enjoy the ride. You're enough, and you've always been enough, and you always will be enough. Your radiant self-love is the source of all other love. Let it in and watch it shine. This is Rachel Steinman. For more information or to contact me with any questions, comments, or guest ideas, please check out rightnowrachel.com. That's right with a W. Thank you so much for listening, subscribing, and sharing, dear family. And if you found value in what you've just heard, I would love and so appreciate a great review on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, or wherever you listen to your podcasts. Until next time, I wish you love, happiness, and good mental health.